like without us? What would our communities be like? Our classrooms? Our arts? Our sense of justice and democracy? Our ambitions, big and small? Our place in the world? Our ability to innovate? Our big screens? Our little screens? Our sense of classic? Our sense of fun? Our businesses? Our technology? Our culture? And ultimately, as the tectonic plates of economics, politics, and diplomacy shift, how will we drive progress? To ensure that we are contributing everything we can as Chinese Americans, we are affirming three important aspects about the Committee of 100. Our purpose. We as Chinese American leaders are committed to being a powerful bridge to the future success of both China and America. Our strategy, to invite all Chinese Americans to fully participate in America's progress. And to harness the know-how of accomplished Chinese Americans in serving as a vital bridge between the United States and China. Our focus, being an advisor to CEOs, being a partner to policymakers, being the trusted source for leaders in government, and being a powerful resource on issues that count most for our community. Our members are first of a kind. From the first Chinese American governor to one of Time Magazine's Men of the Year, from the first Chinese American general to three Grammy Award winners, from 20 corporate CEOs to the first Chinese American space commander, you'll find our members in every major city of commerce, arts, and politics. We serve as a resource to leaders on both sides of the Pacific. With diplomacy that brings China and America closer together on issues that count.
It is a great honor to carry the torch at a historic occasion because China is going to be a superpower one day soon, and we can't afford to have it be isolated and go back to the Cold War days.
With research that illuminates the facts about opinions, trends, and key issues facing Chinese Americans and U.S.-China relations. With conferences that bring members and other opinion leaders together to tackle the toughest issues. With programs in schools, like the recent introduction of Mandarin in our Los Angeles elementary school classroom. And with scholarships and mentoring programs to ensure a healthy pipeline of future leaders. Committee of 100, bridging progress between America and China.
My Chinese name is Bei Yue Ming, and my Americanized name is initial IM, stand for Yue Ming. So I am Bei now because it's simple. I'm an architect. That's all, and not much more. But I'm a Chinese-American architect. You can call me I, as most people do. I think it's probably Tiananmen, I think. It happened, and I think Americans at that time were really somewhat confused about what was happening. So a few of us thought that we should take a position and try to explain, and nothing more than that. So that's why I gathered together before we formed the committee, people whom I respect, whom I thought that would be able to represent the Chinese-American views. And it was in this office, I think. Yo-Yo Ma was one, and I think Shirley Young. I think Henry was there, Henry Tang. But many of us who came from China either tend to become quickly Americanized or remain Chinese. So therefore, to be Chinese Americans is not as easy as you think it is. It's easier to become American, easy to remain Chinese, but to combine the two is something different. And I like to think that that is what is necessary for the committee to be. I was brought up in a Confucian philosophy. So Chinese history and Chinese culture was in me when I came. And they remain with me, even today. And that gave me a great deal of comfort of knowing where I came from. So I think that I came as a Chinese, I remain as a Chinese, but now I'm American Chinese.